It's known as the winterless north, and for good reason.
Northland is famous for its sunbaked beaches and hot temperatures, which is why it was the perfect place for a type of farming that's a New Zealand first. Here's Lucas de Jong.
It's Northland's famous hotspot that's finally being put to work.
In field one, there's approximately 10,000 solar panels.
10,000 of these?
10,000. So this is 540 watts, about a metre wide by 2 metres high, and there are two of them in portrait. We've got about 300 kilometres of cable that takes that to each of the boxes down the end, and then we invert that and connect it to the grid from there.
On the outskirts of Kaitaia, this is the country's first utility-scale solar farm.
It has the combination of being short electricity. Electricity prices are very high in the far north, and it's also one of the sunniest places in the country. And so being able to bring together all of those elements is a critical part of these projects.
They're quite something, aren't they? It's a big step up from that little panel someone has on their house sometimes to generate a bit of power.
What's really neat about these is they're bifacial, so we've got solar panels on the back as well. So we pick up the bounce light, the diffuse light. We get, you know, at least 10% extra on a good day.
Every 10 minutes they move a degree, maximising those sunshine hours.
They move 45 degrees either direction. They start first thing in the morning pointing east. By lunchtime they're sitting horizontal, and by sunset they're pointing out to the west. Nighttime comes, we've got these little battery units in that are charged during the day. They take it to a stow position, which is a safe position for all weather conditions. Then first thing in the morning, depending on the irradiance levels, they come back and they're ready for sunrise.
I was going to ask you about weather, because, you know, they get some pretty strong winds up here in Northland and cyclones coming through. These look like giant sails from this angle.
Absolutely.
How does that work?
So we've got some automated weather stations down there that automatically detect conditions that are unfavourable, and they move it to a safe stow position, so they're very resilient then.
10,000 panels in field one, but there are six more fields on site.
Economies of scale is one of the most important things for the project. So 61,000 panels only work if you do them in a really specific sequence. 6,500 piles as well. These extend 4 metres into the ground. So we're putting one of those in every 4 minutes for 3 months. There were 90 people on the mechanical team that came from within the region.
Work did that stuff people would have had no idea doing when they first came here?
I mean, that's one of the most rewarding things, right? This is a new industry. So everyone that came here as basically a labourer, but they've learnt skills that they can go to the next farm and the next farm and the next farm and build careers.
This 80-hectare construction is called Kohira, a name gifted by Te Rarawa iwi that's been alongside from the start, a name that nods to Maui's act of harnessing the sun to benefit the people.
We do have a high level of pride. We have a high expectation that we can work closely to actually give some of that evidence that shows it's beneficial to everyone. We would love to contribute to the development across the country and showing our commitment to that and how it can benefit our other iwi across Aotearoa.
It's generating not just power, but a future for the people here.
It's generated our tamariki to think about other areas that they probably never would have thought of. And to have it basically here in your back door brings back the realities to what we can benefit from as a people. So I can't think of a better win-win situation, really.
And New Zealand's first solar farm also comes with New Zealand's first solar farm sheep farmer.
Yeah, I don't think you get many farms around the country that have this much shade as the ground's drying out in the open areas. The grass retention and the yield that we're getting out of underneath the panels is actually really good in the summer.
For Connor, it's a steep learning curve. But so far as 240 sheep are making themselves at home in the shade.
The main goal is to be able to have that multi-use, the agrivoltaic use of the farm, and keep the grass growth down so we're not mowing this with machinery, chewing diesel, you know, it doesn't sort of build the sustainable characteristic of the farm.
Sheep is a perfect one because you're talking about sheep eating grass, and the grass gets cut and you basically are enrolling the sheep as part of the maintenance team.
But berries and even broccoli could be grown here as well.
We're thinking of all the different ways in which we can use these farms. It's a bit like a blank canvas.
It's a $50 million investment, but one that'll generate power for around 8,000 houses, roughly the population of the Kaitaia region.
that $50 million is building an asset that'll run for 35 or 40 years, and so it really is an investment in the long-term future of that area. And we've got two others under construction now, and we plan to do five in this first phase, and we're already working on seven more in phase two.
Solar power, empowering the region and paving the way for a bright future in our energy sector.